Hi, it's Cory
and Stephanie,
and we are here today at Disney Springs. We're gonna have dinner at Chef Art Smith's Homecomin, which is just behind us there, and Southern food place. So we're looking forward to some good fried chicken, maybe deviled eggs,
sweet tea.
That all sounds good. So looking forward to getting in there and giving it a try. I've heard a lot of really good things about this place, but I haven't had the chance to try it yet. So let's go get some Southern food. Bacon on them. Really good. Very good.
That dressing and those house-made pickles are amazing. It's enough to feed a family of four, but I'm about to put it down.
One size sweet potato.
I'm gonna try the pickles first. Good pickles. Really good. I like them because they're not too pickled, and they're not too sweet either for a bread and butter pickle. Get in here and try this biscuit. There's plenty of sauce on it. Wow. The hot honey. That's like a honey with a little bit of a kick. It's really tasty. And the biscuits are perfect. They're flaky, but not dry or chewy. They're really, really good. I am gonna enjoy devouring this entire plate.
Wow. I can barely find it. There we go. So cheesy. I couldn't imagine that one person could eat this all. So creamy, so delicious.
So we just finished dinner here at Chef Art Smith's Homecomin, and it was very good. I really enjoyed it. We started with some deviled eggs that were really very good. I think what made them stand out was the bacon on top. Would you agree with that?
Yeah.
Different than you get in a lot of places, having the bacon.
Yeah, the filling was really good, smooth, definitely filled to capacity, and great appetizer, really.
It was a great appetizer, especially considering the next we were going to have the heavy fried chicken. So I had the thigh-high chicken biscuits, which were very good. They had really nice crispy chicken thighs. A hot honey, which was it. I was thinking it was going to be like honey with like a hot sauce mix, but it was really just a good quality honey that had a little bit of spicy kick to it. So it was very good, not too overpowering. And then there were some house-made pickles, bread and butter pickles on there, with extra side kind of in the middle, and they were very good. What I'll say about the pickles is what I like so much about them is I like bread and butter pickles, but these were not overly sweet, and you could tell they were house made because they weren't as pickled as what you would get out of a jar. What'd you have, honey?
I had the Southern fried chicken sandwich, definitely a good portion size. Had a house dressing on there, with also the bread and butter pickles. The bread and butter pickles probably made the sandwich as good as it really was. And for the side, I opted to get the mac and cheese over the house chips, which was only a $2 upcharge and completely worth it. It was very thick and creamy. I actually didn't even eat it all. I shared it with him just to prevent me from getting so full I wouldn't be able to enjoy dessert later on. But it was amazing. It had a really thick layer of cheese over it. It was in a cast iron bowl. Very good.
Yeah, the mac and cheese was great. I will say very rich. Like Steph said, there's no way one person's eating that alone, or they should not eat that alone, because it's so rich. So it was perfect to share. And that is a good tip too. So with the chicken sandwich, it's like $17 and comes with chips. But she was able to upgrade to the mac and cheese for only $2. And it's the same portion as the $8 mac and cheese side. So I think it's a good deal to make that upgrade if you want mac and cheese. But overall, great meal here. Did not have room for dessert, so we'll have to try that next time. But impressed. Definitely think it's worth it for the price and a good value. And we'll be back.
Yes, servers were fantastic as well.
The service was great. All right, we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.